Flying high, you know how I feel. Sun in the sky, you know how I feel.
Welcome to our
daily
coronavirus update. Feeling good, Nina Simone.
It's a new dawn.
This is for, shout out to I'm Savage 123.
It's a new life for
new days.
Yeah.
New dawns, new days. I'm Savage 123. It's for all of us. New dawns, new days. Nina Simone. Feeling good. Good afternoon, Willie Christmas. Deidre Melton, y'all always the first two. Love you guys. Divine March. Appreciate you. Simplify. Tamika Augusto. Little Nina Smoke. Jackie Fussell. Good afternoon. Janet Williams. Nyla Ham. Good afternoon. LaShawn. Good evening. Tia Montague. Good afternoon. Lucy Small. And how are you? Wayne Richardson. Good to hear from your brother. No Nina Simone, feeling good. You don't need no Nina Simone. You need to Google Nina Simone and download this song, feeling good. It's a new dawn, it's a new day. Tania Eve, good afternoon. Lisa Sly, good to see you again. Joyce, Daly Hargrove, how are you? Michelle Coleman, good evening. Latoya Chambers. How are you? Desiree Chisholm, good evening. Almeida Sab, good day. Elizabeth Allen, thank you. Gotta get Nina Simone going. Lisette Masonette, good evening, good evening. Carla Henry, good evening. Irvington, New Jersey in the house. Thank you. Queen Moore, peace, peace. It's a free 6 p.m. art classes for kids today. Check out Queen Moore's page, 6 p.m. classes for kids. Michelle Johnson, Grace and Blessings, Nate Collins, good evening. Lakeisha Dyer, good evening, God bless you. Aziza Khabibi. Thank you. Najira Felix Muhammad, thank you. Oh, I love to hear Aziza. I would love to hear this song. It's one of my favorite songs. Randy Patton Lopez, how you doing? Ella, how you doing? Stay strong in all of this. Appreciate y'all. Thank you for tuning in, as usual, to our coronavirus daily updates. Appreciate you for tuning in, that's for sure. We need this information to get out. So if you can, find a way to get it out to people, we'd love for you to do that as well. So keep tuning in. Appreciate you. Thank you. I want to start this update today. I want to tell y'all, why don't you check out, I don't know what religion you practice, but to check out Chief T.D. Jakes' on quarantining. You should listen to what he has to say. I thought it was a very, very enlightening video. He talked about quarantining as a human being, not as a minister. Maybe we need to appeal to people. And I need to talk to y'all not as the mayor, but as a resident of the city of Newark, an African-American man with family in this community. I know a lot of us don't want to do things because people are telling us to not do them. But then we're doing things because people are telling us to do them, right? We haven't figured out who we should listen to and who we shouldn't listen to. But I'm telling you, no matter what's happening, they're going to open up the state. They open up states all around the country. You need to do what's best for your family. Do what's best for yourself. Do what's best for your health. Listen, if somebody told you that you had to stop doing everything you love for 1 year, but for and 20 years after that, you could do everything you loved. Or if you did everything you loved in 1 year, the next 20 years would be gone. Which one would you choose? And so many of us are choosing to do everything we love in 1 year, and the next 20 years would be gone. You're taking your life into your own hands because this is an invisible killer. We don't know who is going to get, how is it going to affect people, who's going to die. and at what rate they're gonna die. We don't know this information, right? We don't know. What people asking me, when is it time to open up? All we can do is give you markers or points where we think is a good time to begin opening up. We really don't know. You know, the cases in Georgia started to spike up. I mean, listen, there are places in the country that are not experiencing the same level of cases that we're experiencing. There's places in the state that are not experiencing the same levels of cases that we're experiencing in Newark. And it's no fault of your own. It's no fault of where you live. You know, the virus has been more prevalent in these densely populated areas, particularly the ones close to New York. You got New York, you got Connecticut, you got us in New Jersey, you know. And so there are areas that are more prone to this virus than other areas, right? So I was on the phone to U.S. Conference of Mayors today, and they talking about opening up pools and summer camp for children. We not there yet, y'all. We don't live in them areas where 10 people get in the pool at a time. If we open up the pool on Lyons and Leslie, it's gonna be 50 to 60 kids in that pool easily, not counting the adults that'll be there and the lifeguards and the workers, right? If we open up the JFK pool, it's gonna be hundreds of people in that pool. We have to figure this out, but we have to take our time and do this and be considerate about the people who actually live here and who can actually get this. So, you know, just as a regular person, as a human being, as a man in this town, in this community, born and raised, who live here, I'm concerned about myself, my family, my extended family, my friends. And you should be concerned about your family, your extended family and friends. You should be calling them and checking on them and telling them to stay in the house. I mean, there are a lot of incidents all over this country where we see and we're starting to witness the frustration, people coming outside, the police confrontations. Sometimes the police are going way above and beyond and overboard, you know, and doing a little too much. But, you know, on the other side of it, we really need to not be congregating. We should not be outside. We should not be in packs. We should not be in groups. The other day, I seen the guys, they shaking hands and doing the high fives and all that like we normally do. Like, everything is regular. Everything is not regular. You shouldn't be doing that. So just as a regular person, man, I just want y'all to take care of your family, take care of your community, be concerned about your life and your livelihood. If you have to give up a year for 20, then give up a year for 20. Give up 1 year for 20 years. You don't have to go to parties this year. You can go to next year, the year after that. The party's not going nowhere. The club is not going nowhere. Your favorite restaurant is not going nowhere. It's not going anywhere at all. You can't not do your hair for 20 days, 30 days. Come on, y'all. Listen, we're stronger than this. We're stronger than this. It's Newark Strong. We're stronger than this. We can stay in a house and social distance and deal with this little pain that we have to take. The pain of going through this is not going to be the same as the pain of watching your relatives die all alone in the hospital or have to say goodbye to them through Zoom or social media, right? Or people going home dying in their living room, in their bedroom, because there's no more space in the hospital. It's not good, y'all. So we have to be able to take this immediate and initial pain, and the pain is not that great. There's an immediate pain so we can longer life and live better and have greater opportunity for ourselves and our family. Just this little bit, you know, and so many times I'm thinking that this is a test for all of us, man. It's a test for all of us. All of our resolve, all of our patience, all of our discipline is a test for us to maintain. This is our Noah moment, man. This is our Noah moment, our opportunity to get it right, man. This is our opportunity to get it right. And some of us are missing this opportunity completely. We're focused on things we shouldn't be focused on, arguing about stuff that's completely irrelevant, talking about things that don't matter, right? So at the end of the day, this is our Noah moment, our opportunity to get it right, to clean the slate, to start again, right? To fix the environment, to deal with inequality, to make sure people get health care, to make sure people have food to eat. This is our chance to get it right, man, to save our lives. This is opportunity. It's an opportunity. When did you ever, in a period of history, think that the schools would be canceled for an entire year and that you have to be home? All the time you're complaining about the schools and how they treat your children. Now you got to teach your own children in your own house, right? So we have to figure it out. And so we would never imagine we would be in this situation. This is a Noah moment. This is an opportunity, a historical moment. And the question you should ask yourself is, what are you going to do at this moment of history? And what are you doing in this moment of history, right? What are you doing at this time for yourself, for your family, for your community? What are you doing when you wake up The next day, are you arguing about things that are irrelevant? Are you making people go outside? Are you having house parties or inviting people to events? Are you secretly doing hair in a closed salon with the curtains closed? Listen, this is your Noah moment, your opportunity. This is a test for all of us, man. Just as a human being, it's what I believe. I believe this as Raz Baraka, not as the mayor of the city. I believe this as Raz Baraka, as a human being, as an African-American in this city, born and raised. This is what I believe. I believe this is our opportunity to straighten it all out. It's our opportunity to straighten it all out, right? And so we have to, no matter what I tell you, what the state tells you, what the federal government tells you, if they're going to open up or not open up, you have to make a decision for your own family. You have to make a decision for your own family. And this is the first time, probably in a long, long time, where your personal decisions affect your entire family. So you have to make a decision for your own family here. You know, so let's get it done. Here's our cases. In Newark, we have 6,114 positive cases. We have 6,114 positive cases. Yesterday we had 5,965, so it's an increase of 49 cases. Increase of 49 cases. It's not bad. See, we were at 50, we went up, then we went back down to 50, to 49, 50. We have to stay consistent. Those numbers have to keep, each new cases have to keep going down. So that's not a bad number. It's not a bad number. We just have to consistently sustain that over periods of weeks. And the great thing about the number is that we've increased the amount of testing. We've increased testing. We're going to continue to increase testing, so our numbers should rise in terms of that. But the great thing is that we want to keep the number low, and that's good. So today we have 460 deaths. Yesterday we had 453, which means that we have seven additional people who have died in a 24-hour period. It's really sad when I have to say this is a low number. Seven people dying in 24 hours is a low number. It means that we are in a terrible place, y'all. Seven people die is a low number for us. And we're rejoicing when seven people, only seven, which means we are in a horrible, 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 horrible period. And just my condolences, man, to the 460 families in the city of Newark who have lost a loved one from this virus, man. My condolences, my prayers, my thoughts to your family, because I know you had a funeral that your whole family couldn't attend. I know the arrangements weren't what you anticipated or what expected. I know that 9 times out of 10, they died in the hospital and you weren't there. You didn't get an opportunity to go. Like when my father passed, my mother called me on the phone and I was able to get to the hospital, Beth Israel, and be in a room with him. People who are dying of coronavirus, nobody's going to call them and nobody's going to tell them to come to the hospital. Their family are going to die in the hospital amongst strangers, right? So my condolences and my prayers and my thoughts, nobody could imagine being in that situation. Your wife, your mother, your son, your grandmother, your daughter passing away in a hospital and you can't be there, it's bad. Or attend or create a funeral like you will send them off in a respectful and honorable and grand way. My condolences to everybody, man. Essex County, 15,053 positive cases with 1,349 deaths. New Jersey, 131,890 positive cases with 8,549 deaths. More than 3.5 million people around the globe with 250,000 deaths. 1.2 million in the U.S. with 73,769 deaths. 1.2 million in the United States. We have more cases in the U.S. than any other place in the world. I want you to pause for a second and think about the U.S., right? Think about Donald Trump, the whole Make America Great Again, this whole atmosphere we're in with the U.S. being the epicenter of this virus. Do you know that the United States has the greatest concentration of doctors and scientists than any other place in the world, and engineers? Has the strongest, most organized military industrial complex than any other place in the world? Probably has the highest concentration of wealth and resources than any other place in the world. And we are getting beat by this virus greater than places like India, now China, Germany, places in South America and Africa. We're getting they're doing a better job at fighting this virus than we are here in this place. As a matter of fact, there are more African Americans who are dead from the coronavirus than whole countries. You understand what I'm telling you? There are more African Americans in America who died from the coronavirus than all of the people who died in Wuhan, where it first started at. More African Americans. There are more African Americans who've died from coronavirus in the United States than more than a dozen countries around the world, right? That means something, y'all. And we have to take a good look at what's going on here. You know, and it's just not the virus that's beating us. The virus is beating us and the system is helping it beat us. Let's go over these zip codes. 07102, you have 210 positive cases. 07103, 712 positive cases. 07104, 1,228 positive cases. 07105, 871 positive cases. 07106, 650 positive cases. 07107, 991 positive cases. 07108, 511 positive cases. 07112, 507 positive cases. 07114, 236 positive cases. By zip code, in terms of deaths, 07102, 21, 07103, 84, 07104, 92, 07105, 32, 07106, 59, 07107, 57, 07108, 57, 07112, 44, 07114, 19. Today we started testing at Branch Brook Park Skating Rink. We tested well over 200 people today, probably close to 300. It was a great day. We had not only had driving, we had walkthrough. We're the only testing site, probably in the county, maybe even in the state, that allow people to walk through the testing site, not just drive through, that you actually can walk through the testing site. The one at Branch Brook Park is for folks who have insurance, Medicaid, Medicare as well. It's for folks who have insurance. If they tell you on the phone you have to pay, do not go there with any money. You do not have to pay. That is for your insurance. And listen, you pay for your insurance anyway, so you might as well go there and get the test with your insurance, because there's no copay, there's no payment for treatment. You might as well go there, sign up, register, and get tested, right? We were at 224 Homeless Shelter. We tested. We tested at Seth Boyden today. We tested at Baxter Elderly today. Again, we're testing seniors and homeless and folks with, and if you have insurance, we set up a site so you can go through. Probably by next week, we're going to open up a site. Our next site will probably be at the Springfield Avenue Movie Theater, Cityplex, in the parking lot. We're gonna start testing anybody, even if you don't have insurance and you asymptomatic, meaning you don't have any symptoms, but you were around people who may have tested positive and you want to come get tested. We're opening up a site for that with folks that don't have symptoms and may not have insurance. But I urge you, if you do have insurance, go to the places where they accept insurance at, because you're saving the city money, you're saving the county money when you do that, because you already have insurance. Go to the site that takes your insurance. It takes all insurance to go there and do it there. If you don't have insurance, and if you're asymptomatic, you can come to the one that we're going to set up probably at Springfield Avenue, a parking lot in the movie theater there. Just want to thank Wasim Barad family and Shaquille O'Neal for allowing us to do that there. But that is going to open up pretty soon, and we're going to be expanding that as often as much as we can. There are over 280-something thousand residents in the city of Newark. In all honesty, I don't believe we're going to be able to test each and every resident in the city, because we just don't have the resources until the federal government is able to activate the Defense Production Act and make sure that everybody gets tested. We're testing those folks who we think need to be tested first, the most vulnerable, the folks that are sick, right? Those are the people we're testing first, and then everybody else after that. So be patient. It's coming. It's coming rapidly. So don't worry. It's not going to take months. We're going to start testing you in weeks. So be patient. is coming and we need you to get tested. And once you test positive, you have to quarantine yourself, social distance, don't go outside. And you can't go outside with a mask, just don't go outside at all. That's important, y'all. The food relief program. So on this live, we're gonna start giving out 1,000 meals a week. So if you know a senior citizen or a family in need, and a senior citizen, you can put up on a live that you know somebody, you have the address, the phone number, whatever it is, put it up. Our folks are looking at this. They're gonna extrapolate that information. They're gonna pull it down and begin to put it in a list so they can go and service folks who are families who need help or seniors that need help. We're gonna start giving out food. So on this Facebook Live, on this page, you can write down what family you think need help, what senior you think need help, or just simply put, you know, you need food, or folks, you know somebody need food, and put your phone number or email, something so somebody can get back to you and deliver that food for you. You don't have to come pick it up. We're gonna bring it to you. So make sure you do that. We need as many folks doing that as possible. Just got a thing that says they need the phone number. If you wanna go get tested at Branch Brook Park Skating Rink, you have to call 973-988-5511. 973-988-5511. 973-988-5511 to set up, get an appointment, go out there and get tested. Please, you remember, no cash payments. And you could also call 1-800-734-7083, 1-800-734-7083. That's our healthcare center, and that's for people who don't have insurance and are sick. If you're feeling sick now, like today, this instant, you're feeling sick and you don't have any insurance at all, you can go to our healthcare center and you can call them at 1-800-734-7083. So if you're sick today and you have no insurance, go to 1-800-734-7083. That's our federally qualified healthcare center. You can get tested there. That means you don't have to wait for us to set up the site for the rest of the city. You're sick now, today. You can go there, no insurance, no nothing. Go there and call them and get yourself tested right now. It's extremely important that you do that. And after that happens, it's important that you, in fact, socially distance, right? That you quarantine yourself. No, you're no longer socially distant. You have to quarantine yourself, which is extremely important for us to do. As I said, we are opening. We have started a committee to discuss how we're going to open up the city. I want you to stay tuned and stay focused on that, because we need you to be ambassadors to spread the word, so people don't think that it means that we run into the store, run into the supermarket, run into the restaurants, or run into the clubs, or run into the beauty parlors. We're not going to do that. That's not going to happen in the city. I don't care what they're doing in Florida. Don't send me anything about what's going on in Texas or anything that's going on in Mississippi or any of those places, because we not doing it in Newark. I'm telling you, I'm not doing that. It's not happening in this city until we get it right, right? In terms of the census, we had 38.9%, y'all. Sad. 38.9% of the folks who filled out the census. Not good. We have to get on that census and tell everybody we know to do the census. That is just not a good look for us. 38.9%. We're not even close to half of the folks filling it out. We have to fill that out. We have to get everybody we know to fill it out as well. It's extremely important for us all. I just want to your opportunity to shout out 7-year-old Leah Lopez for a beautiful artwork dedicated to all of the frontline workers. 7-year-old Leah Lopez, I want to thank you for the work you did. Also, Queen B911 always gives us a good information. She sent me a video of folks who recovering from COVID-19 being let out of the hospital. And that's a great thing. People are beating it, defeating it, are coming home. And the hospitals are getting clearer. Just like our numbers are starting to get steady, the hospitals are getting clearer. Social distancing is working, y'all. It's working. Social distancing is working. It's working. The numbers are beginning to stabilize themselves, right? And the more we test, we get to measure that. They're starting to stabilize themselves. The hospitals are getting a little bit clearer than they used to be, right? They're getting clearer, right? And so those are great things. People are coming out of there, are coming home. Less people are dying. It's incredibly important. We are reaching a great place, which means the social distancing is working, and we just have to hang on and hang in there. Hang on and hang in there. I already shouted out, I'm Savage, New Days. Letitia, thank you for the prayers. Just want to shout out Mayor MC for sending me that video of Elijah Walker, the bodega on South 10th Street, 288, gives out free food. Go check them out. Jockey 9988, thank you. Princess Sloan, thank you. DJ Dollars, always on it, man. Always on it. Look, Unisex Barbershop, we know you are cutting people's hair with the curtains closed. We're going to come in there, and if the city comes, we're going to close your shop permanently. It's not worth doing the hair for 2 days and not being able to do hair again for the rest of your life. Stay out of there. And if you go in there to get a haircut, you're risking your life. Newark Alliance 60, thank you. Avalon Brown wrote a book called Mommy, Why Do I Have a Cold? Go check out Avalon Brown on Instagram. Got a great book for children. Said, Mommy, Why I Have a Cold, to discuss some of the things that are going on. And our children need to know what's happening. Want to shout out Dr. Horton, Dr. William H. Horton School. They're doing a virtual career day, May 15th, virtual career day from 1 to 3. For more information, call 973-268-5269. 973-268-5269, virtual career day, Dr. Horton. And remember, we are playing all city videos on the channel 78 on Mondays. So if you have something to submit, submit it. You have a video of yourself singing, doing poetry, a monologue, a play, playing with your kids, dancing, anything you want to put up. As long as it's family friendly, we'll put it up. As long as it's inspirational, we'll put it up as well. Please send us stuff. And we want to play Newark-based stuff. Please put it up. I'm going to read an excerpt from a poem called What We Want. And if you go to Tidal or any of the music, social media sites or whatever it is, and type in What We Want, you can get this poem and many poems by the same person who wrote What We Want. Just an excerpt from it. We need a guaranteed income for all, education like fresh air and food and water and shelter, and be free from sickness and disease. We need long life to collectively oppose death and stagnation. We need ideas and imagination. We should be against hoods like sheeted white ones, the ones that take and keep taking from the meek and often defenseless, even the glorified trap. Yeah, we against the trap too. We need our skies free from poison to be able to breathe in sunshine and feel the wind on our faces. We need to end the war and oppression. We need the people to own their own labor. We need every corner of every country developed and every community empowered. We need it all turned right side up. We need the raw materials from the earth used to end poverty anywhere it exists. We need the calluses on our hands and the pains in our lower back to be added to our savings. We need to ban the Confederate flag and label every monument with genocide with a red letter, or just plain tear them down and replace them with statues of women that carried us through the darkest moments of history. We need to destroy all nuclear weapons, but first start with automatic rifles and handguns. We need to replace the war on drugs with a war on ignorance. We need to destroy the pipelines, the cages, and use the savings to develop the human spirit to treat illness, social, mental, and physical. We need freedom, not just the Bill of Rights, but the rights to build our own lives, to be free from destituteness and hatred and hungry children, free from sickness with cures, underdevelopment and cold winter nights with no heat, free from losing our land, our block, our community, our home, free from choking to death in our own backyard and schools that undermine our self-esteem. We need to be free from praising those that lynched us, and free to pray in any language or anyone we choose, free to be free how we define it, free to be free how we define it, free to not live with nothing, and free enough to know the world is made up of all of us, not just some of us, and that only when all of us are free, none of us will be. That's an excerpt from a poem called What We Want. Check it out. God bless y'all. Godspeed to you. Be safe. Stay home. Social distance.